Okay. Well, I'm going to have you move over that way slightly, just because the camera's blocking your face. Yeah. Oh, that's good. Okay. Yeah. Oh, good. Made you smile, too.
Okay.
So this is the studio that I had built around 1990. And before that, when we first got the house, Catherine and I used two bedrooms in the house for studios, and they were pretty small. And then I did a very large subway project, a public project, which gave me the money to do this, to convert this space. And that was around 90. And I made some decisions in designing it that were aesthetic and maybe not practical, because it's a very high ceiling, and I had to decide between having two complete floors, which would have given me more floor space and maybe more wall space, or keeping this high space. So as you can see, I kept the high space. The last 5-6 years I've been working on these plywood sculptures, which are called folded plywood. These I only did last year, which are much smaller. They're not conceptually totally related to the bolt, which we'll talk about after, but the process, like the bolt, is a little Sisyphusian. So 4x8 drawing, zero brush, like that. So it's a little overwhelming when you see how much I might get done in a day. But when you're working and drawing and in the work and it's going really well, you just jettison time. So time going by becomes a non-issue, and you're in a time that just seems like an ongoing present tense, which is a great feeling. Maybe it's what happens when you meditate. And there's some really good, you know, some final finished prints in some of those boxes, and they're all labeled. And I never throw away anything I take a photograph of, be it a negative or a digital image. Sometimes 10, 15 years later, you're looking through your negatives and you go, oh, that's pretty good. So that's why. It's easy to overlook things, and then you revisit and revisit, and you get a different idea about them. So this is the bolt, very simple name for a project, and it's named because it's a bolt of cloth. And when I started it, I had done a number of drawings that were drawing sculptures that were weaves on cloth, and they took various forms. It all started with a square of muslin that was sent to me. The curator had this idea to send out squares of muslin to various artists that she knew about. I'm a little unsure of what the final idea was, because I never sent mine back. And I knew I couldn't send it back, because I knew it was the beginning of something else in my work. So I kept it. I had this idea to start an endless weave drawing. Endless in quotes, because it's not really endless. But for me, it's endless, because it was many yards of cloth, and I was going to start at one end and periodically work on it. And sometimes I would work on it for days. Sometimes, only once did I work on it for like a couple of months straight. And I never did that again, because it's very mesmerizing in a certain way. I became a little ungrounded, a little bit hard to reach And my head was steeped in this place that, even though the weave is physical, my head was somewhere not physical. So it would take me like a day or two to get out of this state of mind. I was hard to talk to. It was like there was this barrier up. When it's going well and you're not saying, oh my God, a week went by, or a whole day went by, let's say 8 hours, and I got this much done. And you go, and you realize you're only gonna live so long, and that you have other things you wanna do, you could get very tense, but you have to let go of all of that entirely, so that when you're in here, and you're moving along, and you're really in this thing, all that goes away, and time just hums. I've been working on the visitors since 79, the groups self-consciously a little bit later than that, unself-consciously way before that, because the groups come out of the same reason that everyone takes snapshots. You're at a birthday party, so you want to commemorate the birthday party. You're at a family reunion. You're at a dinner. And so at first, it was just my reaction to being someone who took photographs and being at event. And the earliest photo that I've retroactively put into the groups project is a photograph I took of my sixth grade class, where I lined everyone up on the stairs of school and took a photo. And I wish I could say I was so brilliant as a kid that I knew this was the beginning of a really important project for me, but it wasn't. And at some point along the way, I backed up and saw that I do this regularly, and it was clear to me it was a thing. Visitors, I think I said, started in 71 when I photographed a friend, and it just visiting. And the first person in the visitors is a guy named Jonathan Santlofer, and we were very good friends. I don't know, I took a picture of him visiting us in Jersey City, where we lived for a while. I took that picture and I knew that that was it. I was going to take a picture of everyone who came to where we lived. And I've been doing that ever since. The whole site and the visitors and the groups and the individual pages will be done when I die, just like the bolt. And then hopefully it will live on in some form, which I'm working on right now, as a kind of something still maneuverable, but as an active artifact, rather than as something that gets added to and changes. It is so much about marking and marking time. I could unroll it for you. The bolt was never meant to be something that was finishable, that it was possible to finish. And the only way I probably could have finished the bolt, if I wanted to, was just to work on that for probably a number of years. But then I wouldn't be in any state to talk to people. I just figure I'll work on it. I've shown it a couple times. I'll show it again, maybe. And when I die, it'll be done.